Imagine if today you were on board a spaceship, and every time you floated to the window, you saw another country or another whole continent of the world flowing by. It's unbelievably beautiful to have the whole world constantly pouring past you like this three-dimensional kaleidoscope. But it also just makes you think, what should we all be doing collectively with this capability? Space allows us to see and understand the whole world like we've never imagined it before. We need space travel to serve humanity and to serve the overall sustainability of the world itself.
For all the people back on Earth, watch this space.
When I was born, no one had ever flown in space. My name's Chris Hadfield. I'm a pilot and an astronaut. I've been lucky enough to fly in space three times, and it gave me a great sense of purpose and resolve. There are thousands of satellites orbiting around the world. Most of them are just for communications, but some of them are to watch very carefully what's happening on the surface, using spaceflight to allow us to make better decisions, but also to understand any impact we're having on the health of the world. There are so many people and companies that are now taking advantage of the capability of spaceflight for so many different purposes.
We've developed video cameras that can live stream 4K video. We can empower humanity to witness planetary change. We have a system hosted on the International Space Station called Space TV One. It has three different camera views showing the beauty of Earth, the reality of our existence on a planet, and monitoring natural disasters such as storms or wildfires, and actually delivering that information in real time to government agencies, emergency response.
For the first time in our entire history, we can instantaneously be aware of the health of our planet with almost no effort. Space also allows us to put up a greenhouse gas satellite, GHG. It just quietly orbits the world and it looks closely, and it's got a special type of lens and sensor on it that it can see some of those gases.
We launched Spire with the mission of using data from space to improve life on Earth and using these new swarms of nanosatellites to really provide a new opportunity to make smarter decisions. As just one example, GHGSat from Canada uses sensors in space to directly detect and monitor methane and CO2 emissions.
When you have smaller satellites or you can have more consistent coverage around the world, then you start to have a really interconnected network that can process data rapidly and then can accelerate the types of use cases and problem solving, particularly when you talk about aircraft and when you talk about shipping, which are two industries that are really involved in emissions. And you can start to look at what routing are they taking and how do they make different decisions there that can both improve their time of arrival but also improve their emissions and how efficient they are being at fuel consumption. You can't decide how to fix something if you're not measuring it. And so by measuring it, identifying where it's happening more than you expect, you can start to take action about it.
Since we started flying in space, people were thinking, what if we could collect direct energy from the sun and beam it straight down to the Earth?
At Space Solar, we're developing and commercializing space-based solar power. We're putting large arrays of solar panels up in space and transmitting that wirelessly down to Earth. Our largest system is 1.4 kilometers diameter. What we can do is steer the beam in 360 degrees with no moving parts. It's a bit like a lighthouse. Space-based solar power is a game changer because it's so scalable. The sun always shines in space, which means you get that 24/7 continuous dispatchable baseload power.
It's a great application of space technology and human ingenuity in order to try and improve what we're doing collectively all around the world. technology is a double-edged sword. It enables us to do things that seem impossible, but of course it has some sort of ecological cost. Most of the things that you launch into space, it's almost like throwing a rock up. Eventually, you might have so many little rocks and little metal satellites and little bits of things that you create a traffic jam going around the world, a debris field. There are ways to deal with orbital debris. We have better and better radar detectors and telescopes that are tracking the thousands of things in orbit so that they don't run into each other. For the first time, we actually now have reusable rockets. You don't have to throw away the whole rocket every time you fly. And so that is a big step forwards in ecological sustainability and responsibility in spaceflight. When I first flew in space, it was still pretty new. The only people that could afford to fly in space were trillionaires, nations. The technology it's still expensive, but it sure is a lot cheaper than it used to be. We need everyone with a good idea to be able to turn that idea into something that serves as many people as possible. We need to build those cradles of innovation.
Space technology and exploration are great examples of the best that human ingenuity, innovation, and scientific discovery is capable of. We are now working to create an astrocharter to offer a framework for sustainability in space.
Our ambition is to have a thriving space industry and a space sector whilst protecting it with a great regulatory framework, but also how we need to protect it for future generations. We're just scratching the surface of what space can do to benefit everybody back here on Earth.
As the United Nations, we really try to empower communities and decision makers by putting the tools that are available thanks to satellite applications into their hands. It's very important that we leverage space solutions, satellite communications, satellite imagery, to bridge the digital divide, to bridge the data divide.
We have to curb our belief that the space above us is so vast that we can allow what is out of sight to be out of mind. We must develop a sustainable way, a durable way of benefiting from space, just as we must here on the Earth.
The Earth is tough, and life itself is tough, but the quality of human life, that's fragile. In using space technology, let's apply the leverage now, when this technology is new, to try and speed the development in order to make this planet a good place to live with a high quality of living for as many people as possible in a sustainable way.